Hey, welcome back to God's Word. I want to talk about biblical show and tell today. I want to take you back to Peter's book, Peter's letter. This is chapter 3 now. It says, "But in your hearts, revere Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you to give the reason for the hope that you have. Do this with gentleness and respect." So we're talking about influence in the marketplace, whether your marketplace is in your neighborhood, in your school, in your place of work, wherever it might be, and we're to be influencers. We're to be witnesses. We are his ambassadors. And so now Peter's saying, have an answer ready. Be prepared. And so I want to make this observation. It's not really a direct observation. It's just an observation about humanity and about Christians. Every Christ follower worries about having the answer, that you're going to be asked a question about Jesus or about the Bible or about theology, and it's going to stump you and you're not going to be prepared. And so rather than put yourself out there to then be embarrassed or unprepared, we just don't do anything. But this is what Peter's saying. He's actually saying, get ready in this way. Be prepared to give the hope you have. This isn't so much about all the theology you don't know. This is about the personal change you do know. Share what you do know. Keep in mind, this is Peter who denied even knowing Jesus on the night of the crucifixion. And so all these years later, he's been filled with the Spirit. He's been learning. He's been growing. And now he's challenging people. We can do this. This isn't about having every Bible answer. This is about being ready to tell what you know. There was a time where Jesus healed a blind man and he was being grilled by a bunch of Pharisees. And he finally kind of threw up his hands and said, I don't know all that. What I know is I was blind and now I see. He shared what he knew. And I think that's what Peter's saying. Share what you know. It's personal. Jesus has done something for you. It might have happened when you were young. It might have happened, you know, in a dramatic way or a progressive way. But there was the old you, and now there's the new you. There was the unsaved, unredeemed, not living for Jesus you, and now there's you. Wherever you're at in your walk with Jesus, you know something about his transforming power. Be ready to share that. So if you missed yesterday, this is written to Christians who are scattered. And so think about that. Here they are having to find new places to live, new ways to make a living. And yet, in spite of all that, Peter still wants to remind them, while you're doing life, be an influence. Don't wait until everything settles down. Don't wait until you get your job all squared away, your kids all squared away, your schooling all finished, or anything like that. In the middle of the transition, since you've been scattered, before everything all settles, before the dust all settles, be prepared. God wants to use you right where you are. And if you were to read more of the letter that Peter writes, he basically will then speak, let Jesus come into every part of your life. Those of you that are married, he would speak to married people. How you behave as a spouse, how you behave as a child in a family, how you behave on the job if you're the employer or the employee. He does not see these scattered people as victims. He sees them as transformed people living around people who need what they have. So here's the application I want to give you today. Be prepared. Believe that you are uniquely positioned around some people that you are prepared for. I don't know everybody you know. You don't know everybody I know. And so at some point it comes down, what if God strategically positioned you and that he knows more about you than you know about you, and he put you right where you are around the people you are because you're the person. And now he's just saying, be aware, be prepared, be ready. God wants to use you. So that's application number one. And then he says, do it with gentleness and respect. I don't know that anybody was ever argued into following Jesus. I certainly don't think anybody was ever badgered or belittled or berated or criticized and then said, boy, I want to become like you. I want to become a follower of Jesus. And so Peter's underscoring how we do what we do matters. So with gentleness and respect, give people time to think about what you're saying. Give people time to ask questions. I think we're all on a journey. Some people, they're so desperate, they're ready to receive Jesus yesterday if somebody would ask them. But then there are people who do have some questions, who need some time, who need gentleness and respect. God will help you with that too. I think you can be prepared to just water a little, plant a little, and leave the harvest to Him. I love to get in on the harvest. I love to be able to be the person that feels like, you know, I get to pray the prayer. But just do your part and leave the rest to the Lord. Your part matters. Let's pray about that today. So Jesus, thank you again that my friends are not only getting into your word, but I believe they're letting the word of God transform them. This guy, Peter, was transformed by the power of Jesus. And you want to do the same thing in us. You want to take people who at one point were so afraid, we can't say anything right, to where we're not only saying things that are helpful, we're helping other people say things that are helpful. We're influencing in multiple levels. And so I pray that rather than my friends get hung up with fears or insecurities, pressures of any kind, I pray that you would release them today into a greater awareness of your providence. You picked them for here. You picked them for now. You've planted them around certain people that they are uniquely positioned to make a difference in. And so give them, Lord, sensitivities to your spirit and sensitivities to the people around them. I believe this will be a harvest season in the days ahead. In Jesus' name, amen.